Members, competition signups are going on today and Monday. Stop by room 103 during your lunch period to sign up.
Do you sing, dance, juggle, play the accordion? Great! Come up and show your hidden talents at Matoaca High School's talent show. Auditions will be held Thursday, January 21st, right after school. Sign up in the performing arts wing.
Our Medford League lost yesterday to the Powhatan Indians 18-20. It was an excellent game. Thank you for everyone who came out and supported us. The next game is away and we play Monacan.
Ultimate Frisbee will be on the field at 2:10. Holler!
Members of the Virginia Reader's Choice Book Group are reminded to check out our Edmodo page for an important update.
Attention, all online health students, CCPS Online will be here during all lunches Thursday, January 21st for paper pickup in the school counseling office.
Come out tonight and support the boys' basketball team as they take on Thomasdale Knights. The pep band will be there pumping up the crowd, so don't miss it. Go Warriors! Don't you just hate traffic?
It's worse than having to wake up early in the morning.
Well, Danielle and Shakira made a video about it, so let's check it out.
I'm joined by Mr. Ryan today, and we are going to talk about a serious problem that we have here at Matoaca High School. Mr. Ryan, what is the problem at hand?
There are too many cars dropping kids off in the morning.
And why is that such a big problem?
Makes buses late, makes parents late, makes kids late.
So how do we go about solving this problem?
A couple solutions. When you get to school, be ready to get out. Don't get out. Get into the back seat. Get your bags. Prep yourself. Make yourself pretty. The other would be carpool. And the last would be, take the bus where you can actually talk to your friends on the way in. I would also say tell your parents to leave earlier. That way we can spread out the number of arrivals in that 20-minute period.
Why are you making everybody late? So it's Miranda's fault?
That's definitely our fault.
Taught the sister, teach the brother. It's awesome because they're both late.
I'm gonna miss Miss Lebo next year so much.
Well, maybe to make everyone a little bit less sad, we can watch a video about it.
If I had to give you some last words of advice, it'd be these. Breathe, smile, go slowly, always be mindful of the present moment. That's where you'll find your joy.
It has been an amazing 12 years here at Matoaca High School. My words of wisdom to students would be to be active, be involved in all your academic and athletic activities that are available to you. And what's not available to you, create, go to your athletic director and have some fun, enjoy your life. But also keep your eye on your goal and have some goals and aspirations for life.
My word of advice to you all is think of something you love to do and make that your career. If you love reading, be an editor, a magazine editor. If you love numbers, be an accountant or math teacher. If you love sports, be a coach, be an official, or maybe even be an athletic director. If you love your career, you will never work a day of your life. Don't let money be the driving force of what you decide to do with your life. And that is my piece of advice to you all.
Well, I know you're all sad because I'm leaving. But anyway, I had a thing all my life because people try to hold me back. And then in your generation, Miley Cyrus came out with the song, The Climb. When that came out, that made that the senior class thing. Never, ever let someone hold you back from your dream. Never, ever let someone say you can't do it when you haven't even tried to do it. I know this is the first installment. I know, according to you, everybody's saying I put the first brick in the building. Right? That's not true. The second brick, maybe, but not the first brick. But always strive to achieve your dream. Make something positive out of yourself. Okay, hit you on the next video. Bye.
That was so inspirational, Ms. Ledbetter.
I know, I'm gonna miss her so much. Have you heard about all the winners? Have you heard about all of our school DECA competition winners?
Well, I personally like FBLA better, but I still think it's pretty cool that some of our students get to compete in the state. Here are some of the students that get to go.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mr. Thomas.
Hi, my name is Michael Follis.
Hi, my name is Brian Valmore.
Hi, my name is Reed Brown.
Hi, my name is Josh Robinson.
I'm a member of our DECA club at school, and we just got back from district competition.
I'm a member of DECA, and I was competing in districts, and I'm going to states.
And I went to DECA competition.
I'm a member of DECA, and I went to district.
I'm at DECA, and I went to the conference competition.
I'm a sports marketing teacher here and one of the DECA sponsors along with Ms. Ford and Ms. Vaya. Just to give you guys a little bit of an insight into what we do in terms of our DECA district conference, students go and they participate in a role play.
I just competed at district competition in the hotel and lodging competition.
I competed in the human resource management.
I competed in personal finance.
I did apparel accessories.
I participated in the principles of business marketing event.
We invite judges from different businesses to come and participate, and students are evaluated according to their responses to hidden scenarios that they only get to see on that day. Students take about 10 minutes to prep, and it's a competition between two districts. We have District 22 and District 31. We split all the schools in the county, and the top three participants are allowed to go to states. At states, students can compete against all Virginia schools, and then the top 10 participants in each competition can go to nationals. This year, nationals is in Tennessee, in Nashville.
Everybody, make sure you join DECA. You can still join this year, and if not, make sure you join next year. There's a lot of fun stuff you can do, and it's a great club.
You know, if you're not in DECA, I would definitely suggest joining. It's the most fun you can have.
To all non-DECA members, you should definitely join. It's a lot of fun.
I think you can definitely sign up for DECA, so it's great on a college application. It's a really fun experience overall.
All right, so if you're interested next year, please let us know. Feel free to come talk to any of us, Ms. Beyer, Ms. Ford, and me as well, Mr. Thomas. Thank you. Have a great day.
But wait, do you have any siblings that go here?
No, thank goodness. But Offer Joe decided to interview some siblings of the school.
Yep.
Here's a video.
Okay.
These two are siblings. One's a senior and the other one's a freshman. I don't know. I'm joined with siblings
Matthew Patton.
And?
Sarah Patton.
So what do you guys think about going to the same school together?
Well, it's interesting.
It's great.
Why is it great?
I don't know.
Oh.
It's just great.
So do you guys get along well?
I guess.
Sort of.
These are terrible questions. You're a bad interviewer.
Oh, I feel bad.
Well, it was kind of awkward to see you with your brother.
That's how I felt, and I really did not think they were going to put that footage inside there, but, you know. Anyways, how are you paying for college?
Hopefully, with the scholarships that are in the next video, I'll be able to afford college tuition. Let's check out the video.
Oh, hey. Oh my gosh, I got in. $80,000? No, I'm not gonna be able to go to college anymore.
Good morning, seniors. Congratulations, some of you have already gotten into college, and good luck waiting for those who haven't heard yet. When you do get your letters, and before you get your letters, right now you're thinking about the big paycheck that comes with college. There's two major things I want you to think about. The first is FAFSA, and you can actually apply to that today, up until whenever you are in your first year of school. It's recommended that you finish by February 15th. That's the earliest deadline in Virginia that colleges are starting to hand out financial aid money. You go to FAFSA.gov, you can fill it out now or later once you've already filed your taxes. There will be a night, February 11th, where you and your parents can come to the school between 4 and 8 to fill out the forms for FAFSA. There will be financial aid advisors here at the school to help you with that process. If you can, bring your tax documents with you. If you've already filed, that makes it easier. If you have not filed taxes, you want to fill out the application with estimated numbers, and later go back and update them with the actual amounts. Second biggest thing besides FAFSA is scholarships, which is really exciting. It's gonna be the easiest money you will ever get in your entire life. Writing one essay to get anywhere from $500 to thousands of dollars. There's a lot on the website right now. March is the big month for scholarships. Right now there's about 15 on the website that are due March 1st. You wanna start looking at those now during AP, during downtime in classes, that you can work on those scholarship essays. Feel free to come up and talk to your counselor if you want help filling out the application or writing the essay, and we'll be happy to help you with that. Good luck.
It's time
for Two Times the Slay.
You guessed it.
Here it is.
Welcome back to Two Times a Slay.
I'm Justin.
I'm Jay.
Today we have something special for y'all.
Called Bean Boozle. Basically, you spin the spinner, it lands on either two different flavors of the same looking jelly bean. You'll get to see our reactions to baby wipes, stinky socks, lawn clippings, toothpaste, rotten egg, canned dog food, barf. This is about to be a wild ride.
Let's get to it. So we're just gonna spin this and see what it lands on. It landed on buttered popcorn or rotten egg.
I think I can tell it's popcorn, but it's nasty.
Ew. That's not good. I like the nice butter aftertaste.
Ew, no, it tastes like when you like cake the butter onto a frozen meal that you gotta heat up in the microwave. When your mama not in the mood to cook.
We got berry blue and toothpaste.
I got baby blue. I mean berry blue. This is good.
Oh, I got toothpaste. It's nice and minty. You need toothpaste because I can smell your breath right now.
Your breath smells like the California wildfire. Don't do that mess with me.
The California wildfire has a smell?
Yeah, sweetie.
Hot.
Next.
The weak spin.
There we go. Baby wipes or coconut? Are you ready?
I don't even like coconut.
Well, I hope you get baby wipes then.
Ew.
Oh my god, coconut is good. Only the best for me.
once again. Tired of this coconut. So let's move on.
If you just eat the whole thing.
Shut up.
Tutti frutti.
Tutti frutti or stinky socks.
It tastes like a fart. Ew.
I'm trying to decide.
Ew. It tastes like Shaq's foot. That's what it tastes like. What yep. size he wear? Like a size 50?
Ew, it took a minute to hit. Now we got one more left.
Lime or lawn clippings? To be honest, I hope you get lawn clippings so you can eat the grass like the cow you are.
Yes, I got lime god.
Tastes like freshly mown grass.
Mowed, you mean?
Moan.
Mowed.
No.
No, you don't say moaned.
Someone was like, what you do? I just mowed my grass.
Anyway, that's it for this week's video.
We'll see y'all next week.
Did you like the Hapar video from last week from Reggie and Michael?
Heck yeah.
Good, because here's another one. And with that,
we'll see you guys next week.
Yes. Have a good one. And don't forget to check out Matoaca WBN Twitter, at Matoaca WBN.
Hey, man, let's learn, yo.
Hey, y'all hear that?
What?
Is that the warning bell? Hold up. We're going to be tardy, yo. Hey, disperse.
I know you hate it every single time I'm not in your class. I hate it each and every time I have to go get a stupid pass. I just need you to count me present, I don't want seed time. I just need one more shot to be the tardy bell. Why won't you just let me in the classroom so I can be great? I just wanna have a good learning time with my classmates. I cannot even afford to show up to that tardy station. It's my last year, don't do this to me, Miss Bradshaw. Is it too late now to say sorry? 'Cause I'm missing more than just your class time. Is it too late now to say sorry? 'Cause I know that all that we've been through now. Is it too late to let me in right now? I'm tardy. Tardy. Yeah, I know I'm late, but I'm here right now. I have no more tardies, that's empty now.
I'm not taking no blame, traffic was backed up for a mile or two. So if you don't let me in, I'm going to sue you. I'll go and just get a pass. Can we let this slide for just this one time?
I know I'm late, but am I still tardy? 'Cause I got a F, I'm trying to learn something. I know I'm late, but am I still tardy? I know class started for 30 minutes now. I got senioritis and I'm tardy now.
I'm tardy.
Did you see the game last night?
Yeah, man, I see Bama got the shit,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Got that dub. Oh, there goes Chris, man.
Oh, you got the tardy pass?
Well, you got another tardy, but...
You kidding me? Yeah, I got another tardy, man.
I get another one, bro. I'm doing two.
You doing two? What? Two what?
Two ASDs.
Oh.